we're headed up to Los Angeles to pick up a early 50s Admiral TV, a wooden case with a rectangular CRT, probably a 21 inch. One of those 50s high boy style. How about the HIV sign with the Luther Vandross playing? Can't get around that one. Yeah, let it go. Left, it said. Oh, yeah. What? Smile. Now wait, turn. What'd she say?
200 feet, then a right onto Park Street.
Okay.
Should I shut her off?
Yeah, you can shut her off. Ooh, boy.
We're shopping already. What do we got here?
TV.
We got the a TV?
Yeah, it's like just a. It's seriously junk.
Is it?
It's like 80s RCA junk. Oh, it's just the front.
Oh, it's here.
They
we
already
go.
Stripped it.
Yeah, roll out on that, man.
It's very gone. They just left the CRT. They did get all the copper.
Next to the toilet. No, the yoke is still there.
I don't see any copper, though. It must be all encased in plastic.
Okay, we're looking for...
Careful here, the cats have mined this very heavily. It's best not to walk on the dirt.
Okay. You care if I make a video just on the TV and stuff? Yeah.
Are you cleaning it out?
Oh, nice.
Yeah. It's a nice house. Well, you probably haven't come across one before that had the original face sticker, factory nice. Sticker on it. Yeah, it's got that illuminized, whatever it says there.
I love these old, what is this, 20s house?
1923.
Yeah, with the lath and plaster, with the vaulted ceilings and all that.
Yeah, it's an oldie.
Wow, everything in here is...
Yeah, right behind your left shoulder, there's an old fitting that used to go to the furnace that's kind of clean.
Wow, look at that.
Is it a gas line or something?
Yeah, it was replaced years ago with
thermostat. Okay. With a clock on it. Wow.
Yeah, that's the old one.
I've never seen one of those before.
Yeah, I hadn't either.
Or did they put the thermometer on it after the fact?
It's upside down.
Yeah, I'm not sure what the deal is with that, but...
What is it, a draft furnace underneath the house?
Yeah, the gravity furnace.
Yeah.
Well, this has got to be the cleanest set we've picked up. We've picked up a lot of TVs over the years now.
Yeah,
that one's like shined.
Yeah, my aunt kept it in good condition.
Wow, this house is like... You don't care if I look around, do you? That's great. The 20s thing with the CFL in it.
Yeah.
Art Deco furniture.
Yeah, some Art Deco.
This is, I think, the most original house like this I've ever seen.
Yeah, it's funny. That's what the realtor said. He said the worst thing about this house is nothing's been done to it since 1923. And he said the best thing about this house is nothing's been done to it since 1923.
Yeah.
So he wants to restore it to original configuration. It's, pretty, one of my friends is a contractor, said it has good bones. I mean, he said it's a, basically a sound structure. It just has...
hasn't been hacked up.
Just has some closets built in.
Wow, look at the leaded glass.
Yeah, much of the glass is leaded, even in the regular panes. You can see... You can see how they're uneven here. If you look at them, they
yeah, because the glass flows over time. It gets thicker at the bottom.
Yeah, some of them are old, very old panes. So, yeah, it's a...
Wow, man, this is... I would...
300 ohm cable here, too.
Oh, twin lead?
Yeah. Probably used on the TV.
You can have it if you need it.
Man, I would love to own something like this. This thing is awesome. Wow, look at that sink.
21-inch aluminized swing. Yeah, ERP. Brighter.
Look at this sink, Chris.
Yeah,
it's got an unusual laundry sink too, an old
washboard thing.
Yeah, it's got the washboard. And,
it's got a washboard?
Yeah, it has an old glass washboard there. And the sink has an unusual base to it that's kind of cool. That metal. That very kind of an unusual metal pedestal there. That.
Oh, that is awesome. No smart meter for you, huh?
Yeah. It's like the original electronics in it.
You couldn't,
old cloth wiring. Uh-huh.
Probably knob and tube, right?
Oh,
in
yeah.
Attic.
Yep.
You see the cupboard, how the cupboard kind of goes up, has a pretty high base on it?
Where?
There, the cupboard there. Look at how it goes back and up.
Oh, yeah.
Coming out.
Wow, this place is amazing, man. Seriously.
Huh, an electric. I would expect gas ringing.
Yeah, there is a gas fitting behind it. In fact, I think that old Cervell refrigerator out in the back was originally in here because there's a gas fitting where the refrigerator was here.
Oh, okay. And it ran on gas?
Yeah. Propane or natural gas refrigerators? Yes.
Yeah.
Ammonia.
So it, just put that on there to keep people from tripping on it. But it, yeah. And the old vegetable hampers.
Oh, check that out.
I used to keep vegetables and,
Oh, okay. Yeah. Potatoes and stuff, yeah, like the screen on the bottom.
Yeah.
Wow. And like this little, you don't see this, like a built-in dinette kind of thing.
Yeah. Yeah, I've always liked the fact it has kind of storage cabinets under the seats there.
Oh, you can open the seats and put...
Yeah, they tilt up and you can store stuff under there. And, yeah, it's got a... One thing that's kind of cool about this house is it's got a, I got a lot of stuff in here. But
I would love to see the basement. That would be, does it have lights in it?
Yeah, I can show you. It has these, this is a cedar closet, cedar lined closet in the back there for your wool.
Wow.
Stuff like that. And so it's.
What does that keep the bugs out?
Yep.
Keeps the moths out?
Yep. An old cedar closet. Yeah, I can show you what the basement looks like.
Oh, there's a basement here, huh?
Yeah, my late father lived in that basement from about 1932 or 3 to 1942 when he went to World War II.
Wow.
He didn't like the rest of the family, so he moved down to the basement. He was a ham radio operator. You can see radio switch instead of a regular.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, it's a toggle.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we both are too.
Yeah, that's the old gravity furnace. Oh, wow. Dual furnace, I guess you'd say.
Does it? Do they still use it?
Oh,
it's got modern fittings on it.
It works, yeah. I haven't fired it up this winter, but it worked last winter.
There's nothing to it.
It's, yeah. You turn it on, light it, and does it ever flood in here? No, I haven't had flooding problems. You know, it's a little old and musty, but...
But they even plastered the ceiling to keep as a fire barrier.
Yeah. Anyway, that's that's cool.
They realize houses here.
Not many do. Be rare. If they have another riot, it'll be handy.
Yeah.
You can get below the bullet level. That's how you do that.
Get below bullet level.
Yeah, most houses you. You start shooting through your house with high-powered rifles, you're in trouble. But that one you can get down in.
That's true, but the thing is the you wouldn't want to be down there when the fire.
Yeah, you wouldn't the want to fire. Be the fire.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Yeah, basically. Houses in a city like this are indefensible. There's not much you can do to protect them.
He's starting to sound like me, isn't he?
And me too.
Yeah,
you felt the same way.
Bad enough situation develops, you're just screwed in a big city like this. Fire will just jump from building to building. They're so close.
Yep.
Yeah, that old shower used to have five shower heads.
Five shower heads? I don't see.
Well, there are four of them that have been removed, but it had
oh.
It had side washers.
Oh, okay. Oh, I see, yeah. Five shower heads. It had one there, back when L.A. had water.
Yes. Yeah,
Is that why you moved out to rural Nevada for that?
I didn't like the congestion and, you know, being packed in the city. I wanted to be out in the country, so when I was able to, I relocated out of town. That was the plan.
This is cool.
Closets. I mean, you'd never find someone willing to put the expense of a window in a closet.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it's just ridiculous.
Saves you energy, you don't have to have a light on in there during the day.
And
it's got drawers built in.
Yeah, they wanted more ventilation, so it has a tremendous number of windows in this house. And
this is definitely a higher end house, you know, for the time.
Well, you know, mine's 1914.
Yeah.
But it's a low end.
Yeah.
It was built by a doctor and his wife, I'm told, as kind of an executive couple house. They didn't have any children.
Okay.
So they wanted a formal dining room, two good sized bedrooms, and one bathroom was considered enough then. So, for two people. So that's what they did. And, wasn't a very good house for my father's family. They had three kids, four at one time. So they were kind of packed in here like, you know, East Montebello.
It's only, the bedrooms are small, right? I've noticed that with a lot of the older homes.
For that era, these were pretty good bed-sized bedrooms.
This is a bedroom here?
This and the other one in the back. And the nice thing was that you could open it up. It was either a guest bedroom or you could open it up if you wanted to have a party, and you could have a very large party here because these three rooms kind of flowed together, the dining room, the living room, and the bedroom, front bedroom. So, yeah.
It has a cedar closet in the middle of the house.
Yep. Well, I don't think there's any imminent danger of a riot. That was kind of an offhand comment, you know, by me. I mean, that I don't think there'll be a riot in the near future, but.
I don't get it.
You don't.
If it's a neighborhood where there's a lot of new construction going on, like where my father-in-law lives, if he sold his place, there's a good chance they bulldoze or
it. Yeah, most people, I mean, they'll like the darker wood, even though it may not be the very finest mahogany.
You know,
it's mahogany?
They told me.
The borders and door frames are all mahogany.
It's not a real high grade of mahogany. It's, you know, it's a. I used to do some woodworking in school, high school, and this is not as dense as really hard, heavy mahogany. That, you know.
Look at this. It's actually got the original hardware on it, and it works. Look at that.
You gotta push down on it a little bit to.
Oh, it's binding at the top.
Yeah, I gotta sand it some more and. It's stiff.
Cool.
Great pizza. It's hard to get it. My life has
been. Well, it's because everything is so dang GMO now. Everything is like got crap in it. What else do you want on there? A little bit of cheese?
Whole grain, you're getting.
You want some cheese?
Yeah, a little bit.
Splash of cheese.
How GMO is this pizza?
Well, I can tell you the sauce is from Stanislaus, and that's an Illuminati family.
Okay.
You better not make that public, though.
No. Yeah, what else?
Pretty much everything is, you know, green peppers, tomatoes.
Monsanto flavor safe.
Monsanto flavor. Yeah, flavor. It's all green, so, you know.
Flavor safe tomatoes.
The oven, Dan style. Oh, look at that, nice and soupy.
You're not going to cut it on the aluminum tray so I get the Alzheimer's shavings. I need my aluminum diet.
You get that anyways. Look outside.
I need my aluminum dietary supplements. Nothing today.
You get all the good stuff, man. They're totally changing the whole the human genome with all that spraying and crap.
Okay, so this is the Admiral 21, pardon me, C23A1A, 21-inch tube, aluminized. It's in Sam's 320, which is from June of 1956. And we're going to do an evaluation on the set. It's in pretty good condition. Power cord will probably have to be replaced. It's got electrical tape over it. Missing a fine tuning knob. That's about it.
Yeah, the fine tuning knob is missing. I wonder why someone would tape the serial number onto it. Okay, so we'll pull the back off and check the CRT. We'll start with that. Okay, here we go.
So we got the back off, no brightener.
I wonder if it's the original CRT. Can we see that?
Is this open?
It is the original CRT. Look at that. Or it looks like it. It's got a lot of these electrolytics. These things are junk. These black. Is that what those are? Are those electrolytics? What are those? Those must be paper caps. Because you notice you don't see any paper caps on this. All you see are these black. ESA, is that what we have here?
Yep, ESA.
Yeah, okay. So you see these paper caps?
Yeah.
Oh, look at that. Oh no, that one's not blown up. I thought that was, it was taped. It looks pretty original. All right, let's check the tubey. Okay, we're ready.
Okay, CRT says Thomas Electronics out of Passaic, New Jersey on the back, and we were wondering if that's, maybe they were the OEM to Admiral, or is it a rebuild?
It's not a rebuild, it's got Admiral written on it.
TEI, Passaic, New Jersey.
It's glowing. Let's see, let's do voltage, and put it at 6 volts, and we'll do emission, red, I bet it's been sitting for 50 years, unused. I bet it's gonna come right up. Let's just leave it.
Okay.
What time is it? Let's give it 10 minutes.
1:37.
1:37. Okay, what time is it now?
1:39.
Nothing wrong with this tube. This thing's good. Good shape. It's actually got cut off. So we're looking at the tubes here. Well, this is charging a little bit. We definitely got high voltage out, horizontal output. There's the damper. And we got a 5U4 right there, rectifier. Here's a tuner with two tubes on it. This is the IF. Then what do we think this
vertical
is?
Horizontal's next to it. For sure, because that's a horizontal hole to adjust.
Yeah, but why does it need so many tubes for the horizontal?
It's got five.
Actually,
tubes.
You're right. Well,
one, two, horizontal.
No. This over here is the sound, and this is the sound right
sound,
here.
Okay. Yeah.
And then this is the deflection, the horizontal and vertical deflection. Got two filter caps. Power transformer set. Good CRT. We're going to try and power it up with the variac and an amp meter. We'll just go after it real slow and see what we get. Interesting, it uses 12 AU7s in it. It's got a 6AL5 for the phase detector. Just kind of nice not to have those crappy selenium diodes that always go bad. 6S4 for a vertical out. It's got three IF set, so it's not a cheap set. Well, it uses two 6AL5s. 6AL5 is that little tiny dual diode right there. Kind of cute. This was not a cheap set, you know that? This was not some budget series string. Oh, it uses the old wide IF too, the 25 megahertz IF. I thought they had gotten rid of that by this era. Hadn't they?
Yeah, maybe.
Any distance it has, the RF has to travel, becomes an inductor, right?
Right.
So.
Don't want any RF ground loops.
So they were looking at these kind of bus bar looking things here with all these screws holding this board down. And I guess that's an RF thing, huh? It's got a nice fuse right there. Okay, since I'm lazy, I'm going to try and use the kilowatt easy, and it looks like it will start working at about 49 volts, which should be okay. You want to man the power switch there, and we'll plug this sucker in and see what we get. Okay. All right. Are we powered up? Go ahead and power it up.
It's on.
It's on. You're sure? Well, it's drawing point. Okay, you want to bring up the variac? Come here, I need another hand here.
How much? It's...
Ooh, heard a crackle from the speaker.
What are we up to now?
We're only at less than half an amp.
Where's the
mark? It doesn't matter. Don't worry about that. We're at 66.6 okay. Volts. Half an amp. Come on, bring it up, man. I don't think we're even up to the point where the rectifier's hitting yet.
There it is. How's the voltage?
90 watts.
A little more? Oh.
No, 90 volts.
90 volts?
60 hertz.
Should be enough to get a picture now.
90 watts. You know, we should pull the cap off the horizontal output tube.
I thought I saw something for a second. Really?
Bring it up a little bit more. 90 volts is too low, man. if the horizontal oscillator doesn't start, we're gonna go ahead, bring it up to about 105. I got it here. Come on, bring it up. Okay, that's good.
Yeah, I got a horizontal. Oh no, I've got half a screen of deflection.
137 watts.
Take a look.
1.2 amps.
Not watchable, but there's a half a screen of.
Oh, well, that's kind of bright. What is
that's volume? And yet it's affecting the.
That's volume. You sure that's volume?
Mm-hmm. Hear the speaker crackling? Oh, maybe contrast? Yeah, this brightness is on the side here. There's brightness, see?
Where's the vertical? Let's turn the vertical.
It's on the back somewhere.
Dude, I hear something. Hear it?
But six is not.
Well, we don't have an antenna on it.
Seven, you get tons of noise, but maybe there's a.
Well,
some kind of issue or just.
The tuner needs to be cleaned for sure. Mm-hmm. 150 watts, that's not bad. What's it rated at? What's the back say? Or does it? No, it won't say on the SAMs.
1.4 amp.
1.4?
About 150.
It's right on 1.4 amp.
Okay.
Right on it. The electrolytics are staying cool, so they're obviously not leaky, or we don't hear any hum. So I think it just needs all of these changed, these paper, these bizarre paper capacitors that are standing up, a whole bunch of them right there. So there's a look at the 1950s Admiral TV that we picked up at the pretty much all original 1923 Spanish style house with mostly all original fixtures and hardware that was super cool. And I am going to be turning this set over to Chris because, like I said at the opening of the video, I have no more room and he's going to take it from here. So there you go. Thanks for watching, and less to come tomorrow.